Genesis 3:15, "And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, between thy seed and her seed." Genesis 6:1, "And it came to pass, when men began to multiply on the face of the earth, and the daughters were born unto them, the sons of God saw the daughters of men, that they were fair, and took them wives, all of which they chose." Now this is important. This is not a regular what Nephilim means to get a better understanding of the scripture. In Hebrew, Nephilim means the fallen ones, those who fell. So that's been and extended 2 inches above. The skeletons were 7 feet tall. Other than the horns, it was anatomically normal. So whatever happened to these skulls? Well, the bones were sent to the American Investigative Museums in Philadelphia. They were stolen, never again to be seen. This happens often with discoveries of Nephilims. Deuteronomy 3 and 11. For only Og, king of Basan, remained of the giants. Behold, his bedstead was a bedstead of iron. Emphasized that Og was perhaps as tall as 12 feet, allowing an extra foot for clearance, but that conclusion is based solely on the length of the man's bedstead. Some sources say Og was taller than the wall of Kutel. 1 Samuel 17:3. And the Philistines stood on a mountain on one side, and Israel stood on a mountain on the other side, and there was a valley between them. And there went out a champion out of the camp of the Philistines, named Goliath of Gath, whose height was 6 cubits and a span, and he had a helmet. Of thy hand, and in the fruit of thy body. This scripture shows two kinds of fruitfulness, that of your works and that of your body. So you can tell a Nephilim by his works and by his seed line. Who was his father? Was his father a Nephilim?